Hey everyone, it's Justin here, and I am super excited because today is my cousin's birthday, and we're throwing him a surprise party. It's gonna be at his favorite restaurant, which is one of my favorite restaurants, and I don't know what gift to get him. There are some people that are really hard to get gifts for because you don't know what they'd like. And then there's my cousin, who loves everything. He plays softball, he plays video games, he rides his bike everywhere, he loves to cook even though he's not great at it. He loves horses and dogs. So there's a lot of different paths I could take with this. For him, it's really hard to narrow one thing down. But I have to make a decision because the party's tonight and I don't have that much time. Ah, incoming text from Liz to her mom. Let's see what's going on. Yeah, I think we all know that Liz usually has something going on by now. And her mother knows her all too well. It's probably a good story here. Oh, well, that's no biggie. Liz is gonna bake a cake for her dad for his birthday. Lots of birthdays today. Oh, is that it? Oh, that's it. As I was saying, I need to figure out my gift for my cousin. So, I don't want to spend a ton of money, but it needs to be thoughtful, you know? So I was figuring maybe I'll just go to the sporting goods store, take a look around. But then again, maybe I should just, like, write him a really funny card? I don't know. Or, you know what, maybe I could... Ooh, okay. White layer cake. Yeah, I like that. You know what I really like? Like a chocolate cake with chocolate frosting. Yeah. Or maybe a yellow cake with chocolate frosting. Or a strawberry cake with... with chocolate frosting. I have a feeling that baking this cake is going to be a long process. You know, it's real sweet that Liz wants to bake this cake for her dad, but the pressure's on if she wants it done by tonight. And even more so if she wants it all finished by the time he walks in through the door. So, as I was saying, you know, her mom has a point. There's gotta be some reason why the recipe calls for buttermilk specifically. And I think I may know about something like that. I remember from my science classes. Yeah, that's right, science. Baking has a lot to do with molecules and acids and bases and what mixes with what and sciencey stuff. That's true. It will add to the flavor of the cake, but the acid in the buttermilk will react with the baking soda in the recipe. They'll combine to form bubbles of carbon dioxide. It's a little complicated, but in short, bingo, that's it. The buttermilk will make the cake rise higher and come out fluffier. It's a chemical reaction. Oh, I'd be disappointed if I was Liz too. I mean, I can imagine her sitting there with all the ingredients and pots and pans already out. She started mixing and measuring only to realize that she doesn't have all the ingredients she needs if she wants the cake to come out right. She can. How'll she do that? Oh yeah! Remember how I said it was the acid in the buttermilk that reacted with the baking soda? Well, regular milk doesn't have acid, but if you mix in vinegar, vinegar is an acid, then it will behave like buttermilk in the recipe. Okay, that's enough science class for today. That's so interesting, learning the function of the buttermilk in a recipe. You know, this may sound a little weird, but that conversation between Liz and her mom about baking the cake actually relates to your next literary analysis lesson on analyzing part-whole relationships. No, I'm serious, hear me out. The cake, the finished product, is made up of a bunch of different ingredients, and each of those ingredients means something. They serve a purpose and add something to the cake. The baker puts in flour, eggs, sugar, buttermilk. They're all separate things, but they come together to make a whole cake. And without buttermilk, the cake wouldn't be the same. So that one ingredient changed the final product. Okay. So think of a story, or an article, or a speech. That final product is made up of text passages and character dialogue and so on and so forth. The author writes these passages so they serve a specific purpose and add to the whole story. Oh, and remember how Liz was under a lot of pressure because her dad was going to be home from work any minute? That created suspense. If she had started the cake a day in advance or even earlier in the day, it wouldn't have mattered as much that she didn't have buttermilk. But because time was ticking away, she felt the pressure and needed to make it work. Authors love to add edge of your seat passages to their texts. Things that make you think that everything's doomed when all of a sudden, ta-da! The hero shows up and saves the day. And for Liz, the milk mixed with vinegar, her own buttermilk, was the hero that came in and saved the day. Or saved the cake. And speaking of feeling the time crunch, I still need to get my cousin a gift for his birthday and I still have no idea what to get him. So I gotta run. Thank you for stopping by and I will see you next time.